Hope you all are doing good, and I hope you all are geared up for the upcoming festivals. I am, and I'm really looking forward to all the festivals that are actually coming quite early this year around. So in today's video, I will share with you how I organize my previous night of the puja or the festival so that the next day becomes a bit easier on me. Now, in my family, I have two small kids who can't really wait to eat their breakfast before the puja finishes. I would ideally prefer that puja is done, then we all sit down to eat together. Similarly, my in-laws are diabetic. They cannot really not be having the breakfast and wait for too long. So all of these put together makes it really tedious on me early in the morning to finish all the cooking and all the preparations so that the puja begins on time and ends on time. So there is a way around it. I try to do maximum things the previous evening and the previous night itself. I'm sure many of you must be doing that. I really don't have to tell how that can be done. I only wanted to share the way I do it in my house. I hope some of these tips and tricks might come handy to you. If there's something that you do and can help me, you're most welcome to put it in your comment in the comment box below. I'll be very, very happy. Ultimately, it's a learning process. Please do let me know. Please put in your comments. If you like the video, please press the thumbs up button. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Have a very happy holiday season. May the blessings of God always be with all of us. Thanks a lot for watching. Now let's continue. Friends, when it comes to religion and pujas, we all have some do's and don'ts that I think we should follow. What I would be showing is the way we do it in my family. I request you to adopt my ideas only if it is okay to do so in your family as well. Well, let me now take you through in the order in which I manage the puja preparation. Rangoli and Toran are the most important part of any puja preparation. I first begin with that. Finishing this the previous night makes it easy for me to focus on the food preparations next day early in the morning. Friends, when I got newly married, my mother-in-law gave me this fantastic idea of writing down on the platform slab with a piece of chalk. It's an amazing reference to whoever gets first into the kitchen. I get into the kitchen completely ready only by 5 a.m. By then, my mom-in-law starts off for me to take over eventually. Trust me friends, keeping things ready this way saves at least half an hour of prasad or naivedya preparation time. As you can see here, since my puja mandir is a bit small, we have to make place to accommodate the idol, kalash, etc. a little away. This place works out fine for us if placed a little away from the dining table. I decorated the previous night itself. Only flower decoration is kept pending for the next morning, which actually doesn't take much time. My husband and kids love to do that bit. Many of you must be aware and doing the tradition of Tambul or Haldi Kumkum invitation. Once I am done with all the major preparations for the next day like Toran, Rangoli, kitchen, etc., I keep the necessary items ready. In the morning, the finishing touches are given by me and my daughter after all the puja work is finished. I prefer to keep a few extra just in case there are some unexpected visitors. Once everything is done, I sweep the floor clean so that I could mop the floor in the next morning before starting the food preparations, etc. That makes me feel a lot more relaxed and clean. Friends, tasks like cleaning up the gods and photos, the puja temple, etc. are done a bit in advance. My mother-in-law readies the kalash items just the previous evening. Friends, if the puja preparations finish on time, I personally feel that we can focus much better on the main puja itself. It feels divine to see God adorned and blessing the home. It's worth all the hard work when the entire family gets together to celebrate an auspicious occasion. Friends, when I was working, I never had the option of working from home.
This method would immensely help me to reach office on time and hardly take leaves. Hope you also find this video useful. If you did, please don't forget to subscribe, like, comment and share. And until the next time, be organized, be productive, be happy, and happy festivals to you. Bye-bye.